All right. Hello and welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather Crafter. I'm happy to be here. I hope that you are too. And if you're not, you're going to be, because we've got some great things in store for you. You know what I just realized I hadn't done? I'm going to do it right now. Everything's good now. Everything is good. Everything is awesome. There's a song like that, you know. I don't know if you knew that. Oh, I'm going to get a copyright strike for that. I'm just sure of it. All right, here we go. There we go. Everything should be set now. We were having such a great time in the green room that I didn't do a few of my last minute check mark items, and so I just had to do them right then. And I think everything works fine when you just do it, right? It's Kraaft It Live, where fun is to be had, mistakes are bound to happen, and if not, I'll make sure they do. So first of all, I just want to say thank you for joining us. Thank you for being here. I want to say a special thank you to my wonderful friends, Sherry. If you'll say hi, Sherry.
Hey, everybody. Happy Tuesday.
And we'll say hi to Sylvia, at least Sylvia's hands, anyway.
Hi, everyone. So glad you're going to be with us on the show today, because it's going to be great.
And she's not excited. No, not at all. And then we've got a really special guest today. So today's episode is all about crafting a, what do we call these things? Canvas bag. Remember last month we gave away one of these canvas bags, and I told you that Peg Robinson had done some really awesome things with hers, and so did Sylvia, and they are going to be sharing their tips and tricks while I muck up mine. So we are here with Peg, and I'm going to put you on screen now. Peg, you want to say hi to everybody? It's so fun to have her muted.
Hi, everyone. I'm glad you're here.
Very glad to have you here, Peg. I'm really happy that you are willing to share your talents with us, and I'm looking forward to it. This is going to be fun. So just like Sylvia, I'm super excited too.
Oh my gosh, I have just been waiting for this for so long, and then today it's like my skin's been crawling. I couldn't wait for the show to start.
Exactly. And it's really funny in the green room, because we're trying to get all of our ducks in a row and make sure everything's going right, and of course we're having computer problem gremlins and what have you, and I've got to remember that it's the first of the month, the first Tuesday of the month, so that means we've got things to announce and things to talk about, including a crafter's challenge. And what's the challenge this month?
I don't know. What's the challenge this month? Tell me.
I love it when you guys play along. The challenge this month is going to be use fabric in your art. Somehow, some way, use fabric in your art. So we'll be doing that in today's show with our canvas bags and canvas totes, and we'd love to see you do something with an apron, or maybe you're a quilter. We haven't seen a lot from quilters lately. So whatever it is that you want to do to use fabric in your art, make sure that you post it wherever you'd like to post your artwork, especially in the crafters community, of course, and make sure you tag it with #, remember that hashtag now, that's what they call it, KSC for Crafters Craft Shaak Challenge, and the MAR for March, and the 15 for 15, so it's KSCMAR15. Okay, so that's how you tag it. And what are you going to win? I know that's what you're just going to ask me, right, ladies?
Yeah, what are we going to win?
Good job, Sherry. All right, so I've got a canvas, and it's wrapped in plastic all ready for you to have some fun with this. It's a canvas photo album, and it's I couldn't figure out how, I could just measure it, I suppose, to find out how big it is, but let's see. It's one of them old-style photo albums, so whatever you do with this, I think this would be an awesome art journal. It's 11 by 12 and a half. That's awesome. So that's going to go to one lucky winner for the Crafters Challenge, and have fun with some material in your art.
That's wonderful. That's a great gift. Wow.
I think it's going to be cool.
I already have a question about that.
Of course you do. Go ahead, Sherry.
Of course I do. Would you define fabric to also include lace?
Of course. If it's material, use it in your art and then post it with KSCMAR15.
Sweet.
All right. Okay, so let's get on to the real reason why you're here, and that's to watch Peg do some really awesome artwork, don't you think? I'm going to switch it over.
Before we do, can we say hi to everybody that's here and do our devotional?
As a matter of fact, I was just going to say, would you please say hello to everybody while I switch my camera? Thank you, Sylvia.
Okay, we want to give a big shout-out and hi to Nanette, Tina, Sandra, Beth, Maria, Victor, yay! You know, the big time zone difference with Victor. Gwen, Lon, Clemencia, Dana, Angel, and Anomari. So glad that you guys are joining us today. And Sherry, did you want to do the devotional?
Yeah, let me put that up there for everybody to see. Today's message, freely you have received, freely give. Matthew 10:8. In Christian service, giving is more than just a word. It's a way of life. Share your time, your talent, and your treasure.
That's a great devotional. Mm-hmm. And I know that Heather also wants to talk about some of the challenges that we all seem to be facing today with family problems and stress and the horrible weather that everybody's experiencing in all parts of the country. Even here in Arizona, we're having inclement weather. I know that's hard to believe, but we do. and we just want to let you know that our prayers are with everybody and our thoughts are with you. And, you know, if you ever need to speak with anybody or need a shoulder to cry on or an ear to listen, we're here.
Thank you, Sylvia. I really do appreciate you sharing that. And Peg, I am grateful that you are here with us. I'm going to I'm trying to click on something, but it's not letting me, so that's fine. I'm really grateful that you're here. I want to just thank you for agreeing to join us and share your talents with us.
Well, thank you. I truly believe in the devotional for today. I enjoy sharing, and that's what this whole community is about. So I'm really glad to be here, and I'm glad to be able to share with all of you.
Very cool. Well, we've got a whole lot to get to, so maybe we should just get to it. But before I get straight to the to Canvas Tote and what I'm going to do with mine, I wanted to share something with everybody out there. Don't get embarrassed with me, Sherry, but I have to share this with you guys. Sherry makes, and she's really good at this whole jewelry making thing, and she sent me these lovely wine charms, and I had to share them because not only do I love the charms themselves, let me just show you there, and of course the beautiful in turquoise and yellow, I like that. It's like green and gold, you know how I am about that coloring. But anyway, if you're not a wine drinker, this is my favorite part of this, and this is how she actually sells them like this, so I want you guys to see. It says, a sweet way for your guests to identify their drinks. May be attached to most stemware, coffee, cup, or mug handles, and more. So if you're not a wine drinker, you can still have these and differentiate each other's drinks. So I thought that was really cool, and I wanted you to know that if you are interested in getting some of these, she's got them linked on her which store
Etsy.
Is it? It's an Etsy store. Okay, I was going to say Etsy, but I was afraid I'd get in trouble. So, yes. I hope you're going to share that link with the folks watching.
I am. I've put the link right there, and that'll take you directly to the shop. And I appreciate the shout-out on that.
You're welcome.
You could really put those to good use, you know, when you're playing Plus Word or whatever. And
yes.
And decorate your wine glass.
I will definitely use it the next time I play my game show on air, but this last time I was not allowed to drink, so okay. So we can move on now. So Peg, why don't you, are you going to switch over to your other camera, or are you able to get it to work?
I am.
Or did you want to show something first?
Just for those who have not seen the bag we're talking about, I was going to show you this. This is what we're talking about. Fully loaded and ready to go with me to my next event. And I'm going to switch down to the other camera now.
Peg, that's such a beautiful bag, and you're such an inspiration. Just beautiful.
And I wanted to, while she's switching her camera and doing all that kind of stuff, I wanted to tell you guys about what I'm going to do with mine. I decided that these pockets are really awesome. I've got to just demonstrate here for you just how big this back pocket is here. And it's about half of that for these front pockets. Okay, and you've got three of the larger pockets back here, and then, what is that, six of these smaller ones in the front. What I wanted to do was make a larger pocket. That's the right one, yes. Okay, so I want to make a larger pocket here because I want to be able to put my journals I've got a couple of different journals that I would like to carry with me in that pocket, like my small dilutions, or even one of these sketch diaries, you know, the 6x9 type of thing, or my leather-bound one. I want to be able to carry those. So what I'm going to do is take a pair of scissors. Don't have a heart attack. I'm going to take a pair of scissors, and I'm going to go down and cut the seam, not the seam itself, but just the stitching, and open that pocket up. And it's actually going to open up this pocket here in front, too, so that I'll make a little bit larger pocket here. So I'm going to do that. And Peg, you've got some stuff to share, I'm sure.
I do. I have just a regular canvas tote bag that I was given when I attended an event. And the first thing I'm doing is applying letters. I'm sure all you scrapbookers have these kinds of things around. Let me know if I get out of camera shot here. I'm just...
You're fine.
All the stuff is behind me here. So... Anyway, you can see that these are just stickers that I put down here on the bag. And I have a couple of different kinds of spray. These are permanent washable tumble dry spray, and I have color wash spray. So I'm going to use those just to put my first layer of color down on my bag.
So Peg, yeah. When you use the stickers, do you mm-hmm. use anything to keep them stuck down more, or just use the as is?
Sometimes I do. Sometimes I'll put a little bit of repositionable adhesive on the back. Depends on the sticker and how much oomph there's going to be in my spraying. So as I'm just going to spray now and let you see what happens. So you can see I can apply color without moving those.
That's so clever, Peg.
Thank you. And just get a good saturation going here. But I like to keep that in place to protect underneath. Okay? You see that?
Wow.
So that's creating one layer right now by leaving that on there.
And you didn't have to do any really major additional adhesive. That's what I'm trying to say. No more extra adhesive?
No. And you know, you can see that I've created some spaces that I can add things to just by doing this. Now, you probably want to do a little mop-up because the stickers get the stuff puddling on top of them.
Oh,
so,
that would make sense, yeah. Okay.
Do a thing like this just so that it doesn't start running underneath. And then we're just going to keep applying some color. Let's see. Let's try a different one here. So, and you can use any kind of stickers or stencils. Actually, let's do that. Let's take a stencil and add some other things here.
And ladies, if there's a comment that comes up, you're going to have to let me know so I can bring it up on screen, because it's a little bit different this time around with having an extra guest in.
So we're not able to do that then?
No, you just bring it up on screen, but I'll have to select it so that everybody else can see it. That's all.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. I was just going to bring one up just real quick here that Maria had said.
Go ahead.
She says, "You are really brave, Peg. I look up to you."
Well, thank you. I don't know how brave I am. I just try things, you know. Experimentation's always good. I'm one that just likes to try things. And, you know, this was a bag that was given to me. It's not like I'm really worried about it, so of course it helps if you keep the letters in place, which I didn't do, but we'll put them back. You know, they're all repositionable, right?
I love it. All right, I'm going to switch over to my view just for a second so you guys can see the progress that I've done here with my scissors. And I've just gone in. I'm down at the bottom, and this is where it gets a little bit trickier. So let's see if you can see what I'm doing. Probably not very well, but down at the bottom, I just want to be very careful to only snip the actual threads and not cut a hole in my canvas. That's the only difficult part of this whole thing. On the front, I just pull, and voila, I have myself a much larger pocket here that I can put my journal into.
That's such a great idea, Heather.
And I'd already done one on the back side, so I've got those, and they won't interfere with the handles, and it's awesome. So I'll switch back over to Peg, because that's where the real loveliness is taking place.
I don't know. I'm just spraying. I'm just having a good time here. I'm trying to figure out what color I want to add next. I need a lighter blue.
So now, Peg, did you put anything inside of your canvas to protect it? I mean, inside of your tote to protect it?
I did, actually. Good question. What I do, because stuff does bleed through, and it doesn't matter what you're working on, whether it's a tote or a, I'm running out of that. If it's an apron, if it's a shirt, ooh, that's strong. Whoa. Okay. So we'll fix that. It doesn't really matter what you're working on because
you definitely need to protect it from, protect the other side is what you're saying.
Exactly, okay. Exactly. So, as you can see.
Oh my goodness, look at that. It's like magic. I can't believe how perfect and crisp those letters are.
That's incredible. I never even thought of doing that.
I didn't even know those were flowers.
Oh yeah.
Maria has said in the comments, she says using the stickers as a mask is a very cool and clever idea.
Oh, thank you. Well, it just, I thought about how to keep some of it pristine and how to... So what I did, and I'll show you here in just a second, is I have... Yuck, this stuff's all stuck to my fingers.
That's okay, called Kraaft It Live.
I do have sticky on those. Okay, so I'm going to clean this up a little bit because it's very wet.
Now,
and
Peg,
typically
those sprays,
I'm going to dry it.
About those sprays that you're using, those are color fast, right? So you don't have to use any of the fabric medium or anything, right?
Not at this point. I toss this stuff in the dryer or I heat set it. But if you look inside my bag, what Heather was alluding to here is I have protected this from going through. I just have a board with a plastic bag over it. And I slid that inside the bag just so the stuff doesn't bleed through from one side to the other.
Right.
So if you're doing a t-shirt or if you're doing, whatever you want to do, you just kind of protect it by doing that. And then you can see I've already laid out some lettering on this side. And let's go with a different color now.
And Peg, can you tell us again what kind of sprays that you're using? We have a question about that.
This one is, it's called Nag Posh Tumble Dye. Easy, soft, permanent, washable, non-toxic, water-based. Which
so
is one tumble, thing. And then
Tumble Dye, is that the name of the product?
Yes.
Okay.
Tumble Dye. And I can't even tell you how many years I've had this. This is made by Nag Posh out of Utah, nagposh.com. And then, of course, Adirondack Color Wash, which is going to be a permanent once it's heat set, too. So that's what I look for, is something that's going to be a permanent color. So I like something that's going to give me a pop, but also be permanent.
Go ahead. I was just going to ask if you would, if you have other colors that are not color wash like that, what would you suggest doing with them? Just not use them, or is there a way that we could use our non-fabric sprays, I guess, is what I'm trying to get at.
Well, I don't always use spray. If you guys look at my blog post from yesterday, I'm using paints and things, and I was intending to show you guys that stuff, too.
Are we asking too many questions too fast? Because we do that around here.
It just, you know, I just have to get to a point where I can show you that. This is just the first layer. So let's do some with paints and things, okay?
Okay.
That's sprays. Let's go to paints. So if you look at this apron, you can see where I've applied paints and things to this. So what we're going to do now is take some other things like a stencil. And I'm running out of cord here. Hold on.
That's cool. I'm going to show what I'm doing. So I'm actually using a stencil too, but I'm going to use something totally different. So we're going to see how this works. But I've got my stencil down. And if you follow me on Instagram, you probably already saw the preview of this. But I've got some heavy white gesso and a stencil. And I'm just using washi tape to kind of hold it down for me so it'll stay in place. It's not really sticking very well, but it works enough to hold it in place. Get all four sides. And let me know when you're ready to show your next part, Pig, and I'll put it back on your screen.
Okie doke. You just keep working away there.
Okay, you just let me know.
You're doing good.
And Heather does carry a lot of really good stencils in the shop, too.
Yeah, let's use one that she has in the shop. How's that for an idea?
You guys, I really need to think about paying you more. That's clear.
Okay.
All right, back to Peg.
So, another thing that she has in the shop is this lovely tool, which is my jelly print plate.
Oh, good, you're going to jelly plate. I'm so excited.
Yeah, yeah. Yay!
Okay, so, what color do I want?
Oh, I saw you do this. Did you do this in your most recent video, one of your most recent videos, where you used it like a palette?
I think I did, yeah. I use it for a palette a lot because, you know, I carry them around with me. So here I've just taken some acrylic paint, and I want to add to that some fabric painting medium. This is from Americana Deco Art. Fabric medium. So this prepares that acrylic to go onto, and I kind of do half and half.
Now, Peg, do you have to use that? Because acrylic, I have found when I accidentally paint myself when I'm crafting, sticks to my clothes with no problem. So.
Yeah, it sticks to my clothes really well too, Sylvia. The reason I use it is because it makes it more flexible. It's just like when you're using UT and you add that flexible stuff to it to keep it more flexible so it doesn't crack and break. That's why I use this.
Okay.
So I'm just going to roll right through this Prima stencil that she carries in her store.
Thanks. Okay, so this brings me to a question I was asking. I asked it in the green room because it was before you came in, Peg.
Uh-huh.
But can I use like a gloss or a matte gel or even the soft gel, do you think, in place of that medium that you're using? The reason why I'm asking is because of how flexible Finnebert's Art Basics are. I wonder if they would work.
I haven't tried it myself. I would say that you could. I just wouldn't do it on something that I'm wearing because you're going to be tossing that into the washer dryer. Like I said, I do my paint shirts and everything this way because, hey, it's fun. And more things I can put paint on, the better, right?
Good idea. And you always encourage us to try, so that's definitely something I'm going to be trying soon.
Yeah.
I love that stencil. Oh,
isn't
my
that
God.
Great?
And Peg, you're just using just a soft foam brayer?
Yeah, this is a soft foam brayer.
That is so smart.
And there are so many different ones out there on the market. I mean, these are the cheapies that I got at an estate sale, but they have them for your other speedball. But, you know, if you've got the speedball where you can change the rollers out, they have them for those too. So, there's lots of that kind of stuff out there. So let's do, since we're starting with
Peg, is there a ratio that you use when you do that fabric medium or you just pour?
I do half and half.
Oh, half
or
and
I
half.
Try to do half and half, yeah. Yeah. So I need to use my piece of paper and get rid of some of that, don't I?
Go ahead. Bring them up.
Okay.
Sherry.
Here's the first one from Inomari, and I'm so sorry if I'm butchering her name. It says, you're a mind reader, Heather. I was just wondering, how would all the different mediums work on Canvas, gels and pastes, too? So good to know that we're mind reading.
That's pretty exciting. Yeah, exactly. And you've got another one?
Yeah, got another one. Dana wants to know if we can post a supply list later because she's pretty sure she needs all this stuff.
I love it. That's awesome.
Pretty sure.
We will do our best. I think Peg has her own blog that she could probably post that on, and you'll just share the link with us in the community probably, right? And
I will certainly do that.
I will link it in the YouTube description. So if you're watching this after we were live, hopefully we've done our jobs by the time you're watching this, and you'll see it there.
So the nice thing about using this is you get a nice even coating on your brayer so that it's not too thick when you go to stencil. And let's do what this one does.
That is such a brilliant idea. And what a fun alternative way to use our jelly plate.
Yeah.
I know, and I'm loving how easily that's stenciling for you because I'm having a heck of a time. I'm just going to switch over to my thing here for a second just to show what I've done so far. I mean, I'm just using one of them pouncer tools, you know, with the sponge and the gesso, and it's working. It's just you making it look a lot easier on your end. I'm watching you and going, maybe I should quit.
Well, the pouncer works, and I'll show you what I do with some of that if I can get a piece that's dry, and I think I'll just switch out to a different piece so that you guys can see what I do with that too.
Live crafting is fun, isn't it, Peg?
absolutely. So you can see I masked some things on here already just to protect them. This already had a logo from the people that gave me this lovely bag, so I protected that because I thought it was nice that they gave me a freebie. So I will, and this is another thing that you can do is just get, look at that.
Wow.
Can you move the bag up a little, Peg?
Yeah, I sure will. As soon as I get tape off my hand. Can you see that?
Oh, yeah. That's so cool. Okay.
So that's just with tape over something that you want to preserve. You just protect it, you know, just like you did with...
That's so cool, and now it looks like a piece of tape with their logo on it.
Yeah, it does.
Washi tape. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's, and then, you know, because you have all of these letters and things, you can embellish those, or what I've been using, just so you guys know, because I know you're going to ask. this is a... Sharpie stained fabric marker, and I think you can get these in different colors too, but like if you want to, I'll try to do this without sticking my, if you want to emphasize your letters, you know, it's going to work real well on fabric and pull those out.
Okay, now move your canvas down here. There you go. Okay.
You're right. Thank you, Sylvia. Keep me on track here. So, I mean, you see how you can outline your letters now, and it's just going to emphasize that.
Great.
It's going to pull it out from the background.
Heather Sandra is recommending that maybe if you stuff your bag with newspaper or something, it might help.
Oh, I can show you what I have inside my bag. It's the bag is fine. It's the stenciling, pouncing part that's the problem. So let me switch over here, and I'll show you. I actually have a very large dictionary in there, so it works. That's fine. I've got a very nice hard surface that I'm working on. That part's fine. It's just that it's not as simple as it is when Peg's doing it, because I've got to work that stuff in using this pouncer tool. That way she did it with that brayer,
Yeah, that was great.
But do you think that might also be the difference between the is viscosity the word I want?
Probably.
Between the gesso and the paint?
Yeah, because hers is probably a lot more liquidy than this heavy white gesso is, definitely.
That's my $5 word for the day.
Awesome. Ooh. You nailed it.
Anytime you are stenciling over the top of paint, it works pretty darn good, I got to tell you, because the paint gives it a little more tooth. So, like, if you're working on a surface like this, that's just the spray on the canvas, it's going to be different than if you're working on a surface like this that's got the paint in there.
Yeah, the feeling is very much... You can feel the texture of the paint is what you're saying,
yes,
right?
Yes. Yeah. But it's still very flexible because you have the medium added to it for fabric, okay?
Very cool. So, can we switch over to I want to switch over to Sylvia for a second.
Sure.
Because Sylvia is doing something with her bag. She's working on the bottom because all the rest of that has been done. So go ahead, tell us what you're doing, Sylvia.
What I did is I just took my ink pencils and I just scribbled. I'm just scribbling all sorts of different colors. And then I mixed up my Martha Stewart fabric medium with some water. And I'm just adding water just to blend my colors. And I'm not spraying because spraying seems to make the stuff stay on top of the surface or something. It just doesn't seem to blend as well, at least for me anyway. And so I'm just... moving the ink tents around with this water mixture here. And prior, I don't know if you can see, I had actually used some Art Basics 3D Gloss Gel Medium, and I stenciled on here so I could get a relief, and that's exactly how it's working. It's working as a relief.
That's cool.
Yeah. And so, you know, it's a different way to do it as opposed to the fabric sprays, because I don't have any of them. I don't have as much supplies as what Peg does. If anybody has seen Peg's art room, it's like a store in itself. So,
come on down.
Party at Peg's.
Okay, so what I'm doing now is I am using a archival ink, which is going to be permanent and waterproof. And I'm going through the stencil onto some of these pieces that I painted previously just to add another layer.
Now that's clever too.
So you can see what it does there.
And I'm frantically looking for my unmute button so I can go, oh, wow! Because you didn't hear that when she first brought it out and I went, genius!
And you're just using one of the foam blending tools?
Right, I'm using one of Tim's little sponge things that you can wash out. And you can do the same thing with paint. Okay, so I've still got paint over here that I had left over. And it doesn't matter if it sits on the jelly plate because you can always pick it up later just by adding some more paint. But I'm going to pick up a little bit of that and grab another stencil. I know I have stencils.
I love the colors you've used in that, Peg.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, that is. Yeah, I do too. It's beautiful.
So, I don't want anything that big. Hmm. Decisions, right?
Wow.
Oh, well, we have a comment from Michael that we just have to bring up.
Go ahead.
He would like to know, is it important to use fingernail polish that matches your work?
Is he alluding to something here?
Only if you care.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. We must be coordinated all the time.
So let's do a little border something. I don't know if that's going to show very good because it's blue. Maybe I should pick something different. Oh, well. Oh,
there we go. That's much better.
Ha! Am I in frame? No, I'm not. Okay. Let's come up here. And See, I don't know if this is going to show up because this was the blue that I was using, but we'll try it. It just gives me another thing to play with later that I'll have to fix because, you know, we always fix things. Okay, you can faintly see that.
Yeah.
But what that does is it gives me a place to use a pen to do some doodling. Okay?
Love it. I love how you've done that with just some of the circles that were created with that bubble stencil.
Mm-hmm.
And how you've emphasized some of them with the doodle lines.
All right, so I'm going to share what I'm doing over here. So I've taken that white gesso through the stencil, and I'm using that as a resist now, using the same sprays that some of the same sprays that were shared. Thank you for that, Peg. Great idea. So I ran in and grabbed some of mine. I'm going to use
Oh, she's using a blue and orange combo. Oh,
no,
oh,
I changed my mind. I'm going to cranberry. So what I'm doing here, though, is I'm playing with this just to figure it out. But watch, I'll spray this on, and it really will go right over the top of that gesso pretty well. And I'm going to put a little bit up here. And this is a little more than I wanted. So I originally took a paper towel and dabbed. That didn't seem to do the resist I wanted. So I used a wet brush because Sylvia taught me that. So I used a wet brush and started playing around with that and realized, still not the kind of resist I was looking for. So I sprayed it with just water.
Oh, wow. Look at it move.
And look at it move. That's exactly where I was going with it. So now I'm going to use that brush to kind of blend those colors together up here because the gravity is wanting to take over a little bit. And down here. And then I'm going to take that paper towel and watch the resist take place.
Oh, yeah. Wow, that looks
good. Is that awesome?
Oh, my gosh.
So cool.
Definitely have to blob it off. Like, what did you say, Peg? You said some much more technical term.
I did?
How yeah, it definitely sounded better coming out of your mouth, I think.
I did? What, me?
That is a fantastic color.
I'm loving this. Okay, back to Peg.
Oh, you guys. Okay, I've decided to be daring.
Ooh.
And I have all this blue on here, which you guys are going to scream at me about because I'm going to wipe it off.
Ooh, I just broke my inktense pencil or block.
Uh-oh.
It's okay. Good thing these work that way.
Yeah.
Isn't there a penalty for that?
No, it's totally not.
Sylvia, some more rags for you.
Okay, I was just going. You didn't hear me, Gab.
Hey, did you see what I pulled off of my roll there? You can't see this audience, but I'm showing this to Sylvia.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, when she said, oh, you guys are going to not like this, I'm going, ah!
Okay. Well, we sacrifice for art, don't we?
Yes, we do.
And I just got to say that the audience is really mesmerized by what's going on because they're being really quiet.
Yeah, it always makes me nervous. They don't realize how nervous that makes me when they're that quiet, but whatever, it's fine. Don't worry about it.
They're watching. You can tell they're watching, but they're just mesmerized by it.
They don't care how it makes me feel. That's fine.
Okay, so that's just putting some paint through another stencil there.
And you mixed that with the fabric medium?
I did.
Oh, okay, cool.
Very good. And, you know, I have to repeat because I'm all about the repeats. There's something about that.
You're talking about repeating patterns, right?
Repeating patterns in art.
Yes. I repeat myself all the time, and people chastise me for it. So
yeah, that's a whole.
Well, I do that too, but
yeah, that's a whole nother ball game right
there. Talking about this thing here.
Somebody find me more paper towels. Where's my assistant?
I'll try to shove them through the camera, but I don't think it'll work.
Yeah, I don't think so either. It's fine. I'll just watch Peg. She's doing awesome stuff there. I love that brayering. That's just genius. Why didn't you tell me that before we started? I could have been done already.
Well, my dear, I didn't own the sprayer until about a week ago. So I was doing a lot of pouncing. You know, I use these things too. It's whatever you've got. And like I said, I went to that sale and they had this. And it's like, ooh, this is pretty cool stuff. I think I like that.
I like it. I like it.
And that's just it. You know, don't be afraid. Go ahead and try whatever you have in front of you because you never know what you're going to get. Okay, any other questions?
That's just fabulous. You got my address, right, Peg?
Okay, I'm taking orders now. Might be another year or two, but, you know.
I'm almost thinking we need to have you do the Craft Shack aprons. For
oh, my gosh, would that be incredible.
Sandra says we need a split screen so we can watch you both at the same time.
You know what? I really wanted to have my mini cam working for this, and I completely forgot about it. And with all the problems we're having in the green room, I didn't even think about doing it. And it's a real bummer because we would be able to see all three of us working at the same time if I'd have done it right. But, you know, whatever.
Well, we work with what we have.
Next well, time. And I think we'll just have to have Peg on again, and I will remember to do it right. What do you
Absolutely.
Think of that?
Okay, so now I've switched to a Sharpie oil-based paint pen. This is a fine point. And let's see, am I where? Let's get to where we can see what I'm doing. Okay, so you see down here where I did that border, and it's really faint.
Yes.
Well, if you want to pull that out, you can just, you know, use that as your pattern to draw those leaves back in. I don't know if you can see that or not. It's not really
dark. Yes, a little bit. Yeah.
So now that's that little stencil of the leaves that you did. Oh,
uh-huh.
I like it.
Uh-huh.
I like it.
Okay. You can do that with the paint pen, or, you know, you can come back in. Let's just come back in with some white. I like to use white. It needs some more.
So just white paint, you're saying, or?
Yeah, I've got some titanium white here. I think it needs some white, don't you?
Always.
You've got so much going on this, and it's absolutely stunning, Peg. It's just gorgeous.
Thank you. So, what do I want to use for that? Let's use another tool. I know everybody's got some of these laying around. And, or maybe not. You know what I did? For those of you that don't have Tim's tools, initially I wasn't going to buy them. So what I did was I got some wooden blocks, and I just put some of that Velcro, stapled it onto them, and then you can put your piece of foam right on top of that. So.
Okay, I'm going to interrupt you right now. In my blog post, when I was talking about today's show, I specifically said if you went to her with a problem, she would tell you not only how to fix it, but how to fix it for cheap and probably using something you have sitting in your home. So proof right there, everybody, proof. I wasn't lying. I wasn't lying. Well, there's a couple of comments out there. I'm going to throw them up because just have to. Just have to. So here we have... All right, so Gwen says, I love your style, Peg. It reminds me of Diane Reevely. She did later on say, I meant Reevely, so that I'm just going to correct her there. So definitely having Peg on again would be great. Totally agree. And Sherry's even though you're in here, Sherry, I'm going to say it anyway, just like dueling banjos, but dueling artists. So, yeah, that would be a lot of fun to have that, wouldn't it? AJ is loving what she's seeing, so thank you very much, Peg. It's looking great.
Oh, thanks, ladies. You always inspire me to do more.
Oh, and I have my thing on the screen, so I'll tell you real quick. I used, in those blank spaces, I took my intense blocks and colored in just a little bit there, and then took a wet paintbrush and started manipulating that around. That's what that is.
Wow.
And then dabbing. I can't wait to go back and see what you're doing, Heather.
I know. That's the hard part
about doing it all. Yeah.
And then I'm just dabbing it off where I want that white to be resisted. But I'm noticing there's a difference. Let me explain something here. The sprays are much more, they'll stay on the canvas better. So the Inktense blocks are cool, but I'm noticing that I have to put a lot of color on, dab off to resist that gesso, and then dab more color on.
Are you dry yet?
No, because I was trying to dab it off while it was still wet. Should I wait till it dries?
Yeah, you know, that's why I switched surfaces, because this surface is dry now from yesterday. And when you're trying to put stuff on top of the wet,
The gesso was dry.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the gesso is dry. I switched over. I've got both sides done, so this is the one I did earlier. But the Inktense doesn't want to stay on the way that color spray did.
Yeah.
So it's staying on as long as I don't take the paper towel to try and take it off.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that... You're probably not able to see what I'm doing, but hopefully it's making sense to the people who are watching at least.
Just a couple of comments here.
Yep, go ahead.
Kind of about what you were talking about, the community and everything. Lon says, I really like how everyone shares their ideas, techniques, and tool knowledge. And then Maria said, yes, that's what's so great and unique about our community.
Absolutely.
Completely agree. Completely. So it's back on you, Peg. Go ahead and tell us what you're doing there.
Well, I'm just stenciling again. That blue on blue just wasn't doing it for me, so I'm back to putting white down, as you can see, just to reemphasize that piece. Now, once this dries, you can go back in with a pen over the top and add things. So there's a lot that can be done to this yet. You just keep layering and layering until you say it's done. So
I love that you can just keep doing that, that even if you're not happy with how that particular blue-on-blue thing was working out, you can just go right in and fix it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So,
and Sylvia, I never know if I should be showing what you're doing or not. You're not talking very much.
I'm just listening. I've got the bottom done. I mean, it's good enough for me because it's a bottom. I don't care. You know, so, and I've got it, you know, all inked up and everything.
So where those diamonds are, that was the
3D gloss gel. Now, like Peg said, you know, I mean, this is never going to go in the washing machine, so I don't care, or the dryer, you know. So maybe the 3D gloss gel might melt if it went in the dryer. So, like she said, don't probably use it on clothing. But, you know, for my bag, it's perfect. It's fine. And then I opened up the pocket. I did a Heather. I opened up the pocket here because I thought this was a great idea. Great. So I'm just coloring the inside of this just down a little bit. So when it's open,
that's what I'm noticing is that you definitely have to get inside of those pockets a little bit so it's not so abrupt.
Right. So when you open them up, it's not so abrupt, right?
We're at about 12 minutes.
What?
Oh my gosh, are you serious?
You've got to be kidding me, Peg. You see what you've done? This is amazing. I'm loving it. So keep showing us.
A couple of things to point out to you guys. I used on this particular stencil another product that you can get, which is this stencil spray adhesive from Tulip. So you were asking about keeping things down. This one has the stick to the back of it so that it adheres to the surface a little bit better.
Okay, so where did you get that spray? Is that just a regular craft store item, or is it a specialty item?
Regular craft store item.
Oh my gosh, I need that.
Yeah.
Now, that doesn't gum up the stencil, Peg?
No. the stencil is just a normal stencil, and I sprayed the back, you know, just like, oh, okay, here's another one. Here's a stencil, because I was going to do a scene on one of them with birdhouses and flowers and things. I've got another one to do yet. Actually, I should pull that one out. And so I put the spray adhesive on the back side of this because I wanted it to stick a little bit more when I'm doing the stenciling on that. The other thing I wanted to show you guys is the stickles, how the stickles works on here.
Oh, I didn't even think about putting stickles on here. All right, I'm all yours, watching.
So, I mean, it just gives you other options for, you know, here's some letters that I painted in and added some doodling and put some stickles into. So just think about all the things that you can put on a surface.
Don't pull that away yet. Don't pull that away yet. Bring it up close to the camera for us and see if you can hold it still just a little bit.
Can you see that?
Oh, my goodness.
Whew.
Now, Peg, will that stand up through washing, the stickles?
I haven't actually tried it, but I think if you're not abusing it, you know, like if you put it on a gentle wash and just hung it to dry, I think it would be okay. I think that the heat may not be the best. And typically I heat set all of this stuff before I go to do that kind of thing.
No, by heat set, you mean you throw it in the dryer?
Yeah, I have one of those laundry bag things that I stick it inside of so it doesn't get all over everything. And, you know, wad up my piece, put it in that, stick it in the dryer, and heat it so that it heat sets. I also heat set with just my heat tool, you know, so it kind of depends on how big a piece you have and what you want to do. So here's one of these aprons that's just a blank apron. You were asking me about this before, Sylvia.
Yeah.
I got these in a 3-pack from Hobby Lobby, and they were like $10 for 3, and then I used a coupon on it, so they ended up being like $2 a piece for an apron. So, you know, okay, so I mess it up, big deal. You also can buy, this is kind of like the cloth that they use for making books out of. When I was going to go take Tracy Batista's class, this is what she asked us to bring to make a cloth book with.
Is that like duck? Is that a lightweight duck? Or?
Well, it's lighter than a duck. I think it's called sail something.
Okay, sail cloth, yeah.
Yeah.
I'll bet you anything Michael is out there laughing right now. It's lighter than a duck. Yeah.
Yeah. It's really not very thick, but, you know, by the time you put a bunch of paint and stuff on it, it's going to thicken it up, especially if you're making a book or something, book pages out of this. So, but if you ever look at anything Tracy Batista does, she does a lot on fabric. So, here's a apron, and because this has the stick-em on the back, you know, I can put that down pretty well.
Oh my gosh. Okay, so I've been looking at like bow bunny stencils to carry in the store that are sticky backed, but it looks like you don't need to. You could use your favorite ones and make them this way.
Absolutely. Now,
Peg,
absolutely.
There was a question out there about how do you clean the stick'em off the stencil?
Yeah,
I don't. I've got several questions.
I don't. Here. You know, it's kind of like how do you clean the paint off your stencil? I don't.
Wow. Really, you don't?
No, I'm not too worried about it. I mean, I do to a certain extent, but, you know, over time, the wear and tear on that stuff kind of takes care of it, so I'm not too worried about it.
Oh, interesting. Something new.
Yeah.
And then there was a question about how I got the lettering on mine. I actually used it's called textile printing ink and a stencil, and I used this textile printing ink, and I dabbed it through a stencil, and then when it was all dry, I came back with this, what is it, the pen, the Faber-Castell pit pen, and I outlined it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I did. And then on the other side with the white, I just freehanded that with white, well, actually it's an acrylic paint. I just freehanded that.
Awesome.
Okay.
We're at about 6 minutes, and Michael wants to know if stickies is a technical term.
Of course it is.
Of course.
Now, what are those? Are you those archival inks that you're using, Peg?
Yeah. These are the Wendy Vecchi's archival. This one is a coffee, and the first one I used was a potting soil. And I'm trying to get a little blend going on with them. I don't know how that'll work, but so what I'm doing is I'm stenciling directly onto the fabric there with these archival inks then.
God, that's great.
We do have several people already asking and signing up for AKP. We will be having that afterwards today. So if you want to join in, just type AKP in the comments over there, and we will get an invite to you. Make sure you stay right where you are, and it'll pop up on your screen.
I'm not going anywhere.
Wow. And Heather, can we see your bag again? It's absolutely stunning.
Sure. Let me see if I can click a button. Okay, there you go.
Oh,
gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Look at that rose.
It's quite a bit of mess. I'm loving it.
Quite a bit of mess.
Here's something that I found, though, in playing with this, is that if I draw with the ink tents where I want it to go, and you could be pretty, you know, specific with this if you're going to draw shapes or whatever, but I put where I want the color to go, then I take a wet finger. Forget about that paintbrush thing.
Oh my gosh, are you kidding me?
No, that's what I've been playing with while I'm watching Peg do her thing. So she said try it. She said try it, so I'm trying it.
Absolutely.
And I can go right into areas I really want that color to be just very specific around those white areas. Go in with my finger, and I don't have to worry about that mess anymore, so very
okay,
cool.
The other thing I have used working on these are the what the heck are these called? Copic pens. Because they are permanent. You know, I'm
Copic
all about
pens.
The permanent.
Mm-hmm. Copic pens. What are Copic pens? Like other than alcohol markers? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, alcohol markers.
I thought you meant maybe the multiliners.
Yeah, I didn't know what you meant specifically. So alcohol
pens. You can use these type of things that have the needle.
Fine liners, yeah.
Uh-huh. Fine liners. And especially, you know, don't throw them away. Like if you guys use that Fiskit stuff, they come in these. When it's empty, wash them out, use them again. But, these are the...
Now, wait a minute. My Friskit did not come in a thing like that. So where did you buy it that it came in a thing like that?
I think Amazon.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Now, Peg, you don't have any problem with the Copic bleeding on the fabric?
That's what I was afraid of, too.
I haven't, but I have a fairly light hand. And I think it depends on how much you saturate it. You know, if you let it dry in between, I'm just trying to give it a little bit of shading on the side here.
Oh, God, you're being so detailed with this. It's amazing. Oh, I love it.
We've got just a couple more minutes, and I have a few more comments. I don't know if you want me to throw them up or not.
Yeah, please.
Let me see if I can do this.
Just some sentiments about the show today, and I think we all kind of feel the same way. Maria says, this was a really fantastic show. I cannot come to AKP today, but I have thoroughly enjoyed this show a lot.
And she also
says, Heather, that your bag looks awesome.
Thank you.
And Gwen says, yes, I love that rose, Heather.
Awesome.
So just as a side note, that did bleed a bit, so what you may want to do is take a fine line with Fiskit and draw around that before you apply your alcohol marker. I think it depends on the fabric that you're working on.
Probably, yeah, because if it's a tighter weave, it probably won't bleed as much.
Yeah, because that's the thing about these bags. It is real nubby, so it's not a tight weave at all. Well, I mean, it is a tight weave, but it's a nubby weave, so.
Yeah, texture, yeah. I just know Michael's going to say something about the things we're saying.
He actually had to leave, so you're safe on that one.
Oh, phew.
He did make a comment, something about the ducks that you all said earlier, but I didn't put it up there. So
that's too funny.
And we are at about time, unfortunately. This has been a blast.
Wow.
Oh, one quick question. Sandra wants to know, what is Fiskit? And I don't know what that is either.
Oh, it's that water, the watercolor stuff that you used, Sandra, to create your words create and stuff. That's called Fiskit. The stuff
it's a mask.
That you would, mask. Thank you. That's the word I was looking for.
So is it like rubber cement?
It's similar.
Sure. Oh, okay.
Yeah, rubber cement's so much cheaper, people. Remember that.
It's not the same, though. It's not the same, but it's similar.
There's a fine line applicator with masking fluid.
Oh, okay. Love it.
Technical. I love it.
Love so it. If you're trying to outline something like this to keep it contained, this is kind of what you would want.
Great.
Wow. Very cool. Excellent. All right, well, I will go ahead and end the show here while we're watching Peg and her beautiful artwork there. I just love how she's just so very daintily stenciling away there. That's just beautiful.
And all the ideas. Oh, my gosh.
I know. I'm sorry. I can't stay for after Crafter Party. I have stuff that I need to go do with my art, but I'm just kidding. So I will see you if you are joining us. After the show has aired live, please consider joining the Crafters community. It is a G+ community, and you will not be sorry, because you get to see a lot of Peg's work, a lot of Sylvia's work, Sherry's work. We've got a ton of talented folks who do a bunch of wonderful postings almost every single day. So please, join us over at Crafters community, and Peg, you're going to get that list up, right?
I will. I'm going to briefly,
it's
if there's
take
room,
us a
I'll stop
while.
In the Aftercraft party if there's any more questions.
That's a good idea.
I do have to run out for a little while today. I was meeting a friend, but I will get it up tonight and have it on the blog for you guys, okay?
Awesome. Excellent. All right. So, again, if you're staying for Aftercrafter, we'll be sending you an invite shortly. Thank you again, everybody. Have a crafty day. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.